All right, so this is game one of three for this night, and we're going to cover these pads a little bit at the end of this video. So if you want to know some things about this, we'll talk a little bit about that there, and then a full review will come, hopefully in a little bit. But anyways, this game, this is the Stars team that I'm on. They're one of the lower teams, usually bottom two or three in the league, and the team we're playing against is top three-ish. They've, like, the top few teams have been going back and forth, so they're between second and like fourth, and they're good, and they've beaten all my teams this year so far, and like, they're a solid team. So this is definitely a good matchup in terms of work and everything, so we'll see how this one goes down. So if you're buying hockey equipment and you want to support the channel, check out the links in the description. In the US, check out the links to Pure Hockey. In Canada, check out the links to Hockey Supremacy. If you click those links and make a purchase, I get a kickback from the sale. So anything that comes back from that comes right back into the channel, so I can make more content and doing like real reviews and stuff. I got buy gear to do a lot of the tests for it, so that costs money and it would be greatly appreciated. Otherwise, if you want to support the channel without buying anything, check out the links in the description to Patreon, buy me a coffee. Everything through there comes again back into the channel, so I can make more content and doing real reviews.
Y'all ready for this?
Round.
So this was actually like a pretty solid game all around. We knew we were outmatched. They're a really good team and we're one of the bottom teams, and losing 3-1 with empty net is almost a win. Like, it's disappointing, but at the same time, like, you feel good about your performance. I thought I played pretty solid in this one. Everything felt really good. I feel like I made a lot of like pretty solid saves and everything. And it like kept them for a while before they actually like scored. And then they like didn't get a ton, obviously, but it was just like, it kind of sucked. First goal, I still don't know how it went in. I've gone frame by frame in this video to see exactly how this went in. And I don't know where this rebound goes. I don't know if it goes off my knee and then off my other knee and kind of just like trickles under my pad right here and kind of goes in. But when it looks like it goes in, it looks like it's in the air. So I think what happened is it went blocker side and just like rolled down my body type thing and off my pad and in. Maybe I kicked it in and maybe it was just under me the whole time and my leg movements kicked it in, but it looks like it comes off too hard for how, like, where my leg is sliding. But I have no clue how this one went in. It was disappointing because I made a pretty good save and I knew there was all that traffic there. So I just tried to get rid of the puck and I threw it right back to another guy and then they put in the rebound. So that always feels bad and sucks. The second goal is against a guy who, I think this is the first game I played against him, either the first or second time I played against him in this league, and every time since he scored, and he does it again here. I played this whole play, I thought, pretty well. I was square with his body though and not the shot or his stick, so basically I was off angle by about that much, and he put it posted in. Like, it couldn't have been a better shot. I almost had it with my glove, and if I was maybe like angled to the puck, it would have been a save, but I didn't want to give him far side, so I kind of played there, and I knew there was also a guy like in the middle of the ice, so it was kind of me trying to play a little bit, not numbers game, but like not just commit all to him. Great shot, and again, not totally square, so it really sucks for that. And then the last one is obviously an empty net, so there's nothing to do about it. Like, overall, the team played pretty good. We didn't give up like many crazy chances. Pretty good defensively. Usually this team makes some really bad defensive plays where it's just like, oh, here's three breakaways, or like here's a 3-on-0 type thing, and it wasn't that bad this game, so I did a pretty good job for that. Now for these pads, I've had a ton of people ask for a review on these, and I don't know why I haven't totally got to it yet, but we will get there. And these pads are kind of hard to play multiple games in a row with because this knee block sucks so bad. And by sucks, I mean is so hard. This block, like right here, feels like a hard plastic. It's not, it's a foam, but it's a very, very hard, hard foam. And even like this piece right here, which is supposed to be for padding, doesn't do enough. So if I play more than 1 hour in a row with these, my knees are destroyed. They hurt so bad. And it is from landing on this block. And in order for me to wear these pads more than an hour, and in order for me to wear them more than 1 day in a row, so if I wear these like on a Monday, I can't wear them on a Tuesday because my knees will hurt too much. I have to wear like padded underneath my knee pads. So double padded layer basically, and I wear Bauer pour on knee pads to add to it so my knees aren't killing themselves. Like, this thing is so hard that it just kills. So if you're buying these, think of that and ask them to beef this padding in some way, just because this middle block hurts way too much. It's like the only pad I've worn in a very, very, very long time where my knees just get destroyed after using them. And I've had some people were like, oh, well, like, you must be missing the block. I'm not missing the block. I'm hitting the block. And they're like, oh, well, I don't have the issues. And I'm like, well, I can't play the next day with them. So like, if I do 2 hours by the second game, my knees hurt so bad I don't want to drop. So I need to have that padded knee pad. So that's kind of nuts on that too. Also for stiffness, this is the stiffest pad they would make. And it's getting softer and softer, but this is good. This is how it should be stock. The stock ones are way too soft. And we'll show that off as well. But sliding on these is unreal. It's still the best by, like, the only thing better than these really is that Warrior with the slide plate. But even then, these slide better on like good ice conditions, and the Warrior slide better on bad ice conditions. So it's like half and half, if that makes sense. But I think I'll do a full review of this very shortly. It's my next goalie piece of like actual review. So we'll talk about that hopefully soon, because I know a lot of people want to see it.
You're watching HockeyReviews.ca.